Hi, me again with the two x32s. In the previous video I show you how x32 commander worked by basically moving one fader to the other console and also moving synchronized. I got in contact with Sir Patrick Maillot, and in the Facebook group there were a lot of questions about can you do this and it's not possible. And well, once again, Sir Patrick Gilles Maillot commented me in this Facebook group, and I'm really, really happy he did. And he just said, just opening my program, if you want to mirror anything from the master console to the slave console or secondary console, just put in O and then the star sign, and then save the file, open my program, put in IP addresses, connect everything together via internet, of course, and then you should have a complete mirror from the first console to the second console. I was like, okay, that will be fantastic, because I was looking at his manual, and indeed you can do everything, or I have the feeling you can do everything, because the OSC is sending everything. So this is basically what I did. I've set up this console, by the way, with my surround 5.1 Dolby Atmos, whatever. And as you see, I have a couple of things here, and I have here a completely different project loaded. So this also proves that the two consoles are set up completely different, because I also want to show you something else. I was playing a little bit with this before I made this video, just to be mind-blowing, of course. And when it worked, I was really mind-blowing. If I load up this one, me and my crew, this will send out every setting. So it will send out scene via OAS to that one. Look what happened when I'm going to load in this show. You see what it does? It sent that one, already had like the same show. So maybe it's not a fair one, but as you saw, there were a couple of things were moving. Now, people will, of course, ask, okay, this is really cool, but why your mind was blown? Because everything what I'm going to do here, I'm going to show over here. I'm going to move fader number one. I'm going to move fader number two, just like the last time. Right now, I can also start to mute everything, or a couple of things I can, of course, mute. I can do a whole bunch if I want. What also is working, of course, not only fader control is working, but look what happened if I, for instance, going to press view over here. You see the screen over here, you see the screen over there. If I come to press view here, the screen here is changing. I go to select channel number one, and there we have channel number one. Everything what I did over here also happened over here. There's nobody in the room who did change this screen. Because if I now press, for instance, setup, you go to the setup menu. If I change something here in this menu, unfortunately, I don't know if this is something Peter Maillot have to explain me how this works, but the selection is not, this is not working. But the majority is working. And that's really, really fantastic, because if, for instance, I have here the kick drum, kick drum in, kick drum out, blah, yada, yada, and if I want to change the EQ, note that both of the consoles has the same show file, so also the same equalization. But when I going to move here, this one, the low, mid, and I'm going to boost or cut some frequencies, it's exactly doing the same over there. It's doing exactly the same. Somebody asked me, is CentOn fader working? CentOn fader is working. Can I show you CentOn fader working? Sure I can. If I now, I have channel 1 selected, and if I move this one up, it's working. You can also, because it's the full size, you can also see it working over here. And it's also, of course, in correlation with this one. What also is working is DCAs. But it's working a little bit. If I press DCAs here, of course, the layer over there is going to change to DCA. But if I'm going to select the DCA here, and I see my channels inside of DCA, one, here it's not opening. But, for sure, if I change something over here, I already tested, if I open this one, it's not changing anything on the layer, but if you open the DCA here, so you view the DCA inside of this X32, it's moving it as well. So that's a little bit strange, but it's changing what you're doing over here. It's telling this mixer to replicate, and change also as well. As you see, it's also not... if you change here your DCAs over here, it's not changing the layers over here. Only when you, I'm not sure. Okay, when you doing this, then it will change it up. Okay. Then somebody asked me effects, and well, effects is also, I assume effects are working the same way. Effects, even though are working, if you're changing the values, that's working, so that's not a problem. That's also is working simultaneously. Also here, view is working, that's really nice. If I go for the buses, that's also working. If I open the USB over here, that's doing it. Even, and that's maybe quite funny, you can even control the light remotely. So that's quite cool as well. You can turn the light lamp on and off. Wait, let me get the light. Let me get that light. Oh, wait, this may be funny to show. I'm going to plug in my light. It's a one-hand job. Nice. That's maybe funny to show. I'm going to control the light remote. Well, that's of course really funny. So everything is, let's say, synchronized. The only thing I could not found in this setup is routing. When I change routing over here, when I twist the, let's say, the rotary over here, it's not changing the parameters there. If I select local one, oh, even though, wait,
Oh, wait, that's. Oh, great. Okay, great. Well, so it's not. Okay.
So I'm wrong. Even the routing is working. So that's very awesome.
So even the routing is working. That's super cool. That's really mind-blowing. So the only thing that's not, of course, not maybe not working is, of course, your setup menu and but everything else should work. I don't know what. Oh, dhcp is also changing. Okay, so that is working. So the final answer in this 10-minute long video, can you remote 1x32 or mirror an x32 to a second x32? Yes, the final answer is yes. You can remote an x32 to a second x32. So, for worshipping, I would say get an x32 full size at home. Get like an x32 rack in your local worshipping house, or maybe as well an x32 full size, and mix it. I don't know why. I don't know. If, I don't know. You can, let's say, assist your guy or whatever. Maybe you can in this way remote, if you have the same scene, of course, set up and you, because central fader is also working. So if you both load in the same file for the show, or you make a, I don't even know if you may going to make. Let me check something. I don't know if I, for example, going to adjust channel 16 to, let's say, a different picture. Is that also going to reflect? Oh, the picture is also going to reflect, and also the naming is changing. So I now set it up as a crowd microphone. So yeah. For what I can see is, if you want to work from home and you have using some live feed like a stereo pair of, so you're sending out your monitoring bus or whatever you want to send via, let's say, a streaming. There are lots of ways to do this actually. You can. You absolutely can. You absolutely can control with the master x32 the slave x32. I would also like to see it the other way around, but this is really, really cool. Okay, once again, thanks. Maybe this video was a little bit lengthy, but if somebody else wants to see something more or whatever, it's definitely really, really cool. Like I said, I don't for myself, I really don't see a good purpose, but maybe for worshipping, if you are working from home, you can just go for, if you're mixing, like say, from this console is at home and that one is in the church or in your worshipping house or whatever, I would say you can pretty much mix your live stream from home on a console. And your worshiping console is still doing the full audio mix. And you can just adjust whatever you want. I think it's a great deal. I think it's awesome. Okay. Once again, thanks for watching. And also thanks for Peter Malotte, Gilles Malotte, for reaching out to me. This is really, really cool and really interesting. Once again, have a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. I'm going to add a little bit to the video. I was still after the video a little bit messing with the consoles, and I was thinking it was bothering me that why you cannot control with this mixer, also that mixer, and with that mixer, this mixer. Why is it not, let's say, like a backup solution? And of course, you can. The other day I was trying it, but then it doesn't work. But right now I just have in my MacBook, I just running like a Windows 10 on top of my MacBook, but doesn't matter because the Peter Maillot application only works in macOS or Windows. But if you're running two instances of this beautiful program, you cannot only have the master console controlling the slave console, but the slave console becomes the master console of the master console. Does that make any sense? Well, let me show you. I cannot only move the master fader here, but I can also move the master fader there. How awesome is this? You can now basically set up two mixers. Both can receive audio. Or, and this may be more interesting, you can have a student mixing at one console, a teacher on the second one, and just say to your student, you mix in the front of house today. I will not stand behind you, but I set up this console to assist you in any case if something is going wrong. So in that perspective, if you can use this, let's say, as a teaching station, as a teaching setup, that's really handy. That's really cool. If I now have, let's say, a student, I can basically set up a second X32, or I can use an X32 and give him an M32, because who cares if you're using an X32 to control, it doesn't matter. But this is really cool, Patrick Maillot. This is really, really cool stuff. Okay, once again, thanks for watching, and I hope somebody find this also interesting. Once again, I don't really see. Still, I have to figure out what I have to do. But at the moment, I also have to say that I'm a little bit speechless that this is possible. But this is really, really cool. Thanks for watching again. Ciao.